मॉर्निंग टू एवरीवन, माय नेम इज आबिद हुसैन, आई एम परसुइंग बी फार्म सेकंड ईयर इन राघवेंद्र इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज आइसोटोनिक एंड बफर सॉल्यूशन। द नेम इटसेल्फ इंडिकेट्स, फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट आइसोटोनिक सॉल्यूशन। द नेम इटसेल्फ इंडिकेट्स दैट आइसो मींस सेम, हैविंग सेम कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, द टू सॉल्यूशंस हैविंग सेम कॉन्सेंट्रेशन। वी कैन से दैट द एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर फ्लूइड हैविंग सेम osmolarity, having same osmolarity with respect to the cell, it indicates that having isotonic solution. If blood is if body is isotonic with the blood, then it will be useful during giving saline process. When saline is giving to the body, the 0.9% of saline is giving to the body because it is isotonic to the blood, so it is useful. Then if the body is not isotonic to the fluid, then it leads to so many complications. Like if the fluid is not isotonic, that means hypotonic. Suppose take this as a cell, and this is extracellular fluid, and the solution is said to be hypotonic when the concentration of dissolved solutes are more inside the cell when compared to outside. Then it indicates that water is high outside the cell, and when inside the cell water is low. Here concentration of dissolved solutes are more, but here is less. That indicates the movement of water takes place inside the cell. Then it leads to swelling of cell and leads to burst of cell. Then it leads to so many complications. So if the cell is hypotonic, then cell swelling is takes place. If the solution is hypertonic, the cell is hypertonic. It indicates that consider it as a cell. Here extracellular fluid having more concentration when compared to the cell. Here the solute particles are more, but here solute particles are very less. It indicates that the movement of water takes place outside the cell, because the movement of water comes out from the cell. It leads to shrinkage of cell. Then it leads to the cell will be cell become dysfunction. So the body should maintain isotonic solution. If body is not maintaining isotonic solution, then it leads to so many problems like cell damage, cell dysfunctioning, like different things will happen. So we should maintain isotonic to the body fluids. We have so many examples like 0.9% of NaCl is isotonic to the blood. So many people, when person is suffering from nutrient deficiency, at that time the 0.9% NaCl will be given to the patient, because 0.9% is the isotonic to the blood. Because isotonic indicates that, suppose consider it as a cell, the amount of solute particles or water in the same condition at the extracellular fluids, the amount of water and the solute particles are same. Here three particles are there, so concentration particles. Here also three particles are there. So the movement of water from outside to cell or inside to cell will be equal. The net gain of water inside the cell or outside the cell will be equal. So if the body is made in isotonic solution, then it will be helpful to the body. So 0.9% will be in 0.9% in NaCl will be the isotonic to the blood. At the same time, another we have example, that is 5% of dextrose. 5% of dextrose will be the isotonic to the body. In this way, we have two examples which will be isotonic to the body. And I want to tell one more thing. Suppose we have another topic, that isotonic adjusting substance. The name itself indicates that isotonicity, adjusting substance. The substance which is used to adjust the tonicity. Suppose we have taken one beaker. This is S drug amount, having solution. S drug amount of solution. It is not isotonic to the body. Then we have to add adjusting substance. NaCl. If we add NaCl, then it will be adjust to the isotonicity. It is called adjusting substance. NaCl. And not only NaCl, we have so many examples adjusting substances like sodium sulfate, sucrose, urea, and different electrolytes which will be adjusting the isotonicity. And in this way we have so many adjusting substances. And some more are this zinc sulfate and magnesium sulfate. These are examples of the adjusting substance for the isotonicity. Related to adjusting substance, I want to discuss one problem. A pharmacist, he has been given a prescription that he want to prepare 0.5% weight by volume chloroquinicol. I understand the pharmacist has received one prescription that he want to prepare 0.5% weight by volume 10 ml 0.5 weight by volume of chloroquinicol. And now we have to calculate how much amount of NaCl is required. How much amount of NaCl is required to maintain isotonicity with the chloroquinicol. And now we have to calculate how much amount of NaCl is required to make isotonic with the chloroquinicol. Now we have to see what is the freezing point of depression. I have told that we have so many methods, but I am discussing about sodium chloride equivalent method. And to calculate this we have to know first the freezing point depression of chloroquinicol is 0.06%. Freezing point of chloroquinicol is 0.06%. And when we are seeing NaCl, the freezing point depression is for 1% NaCl, the freezing point depression is 0.576. But when we are seeing for 0.9% NaCl, 0.52 degree centigrade. And the freezing point of chloroquinicol is 0.06%. Now we have to calculate, and the freezing point depression of chloroquinicol is 0.06%. Now just imagine, this is standard value for 1%. For 1% chloroquinicol, this is 0.06%. For 0.05%, how much freezing point depression we need? Can you tell? 0.03. And this is, and the freezing point depression for 0.05% is 0.03. Now we have to calculate how much amount of sodium is required. 0.52 degree centigrade for it is the main freezing point. But here due to adding drug the freezing point has decreased to 0.03. And when we minus from this, we get 0.49.
Right there.
First, we have to calculate total freeze point.
Freeze point is equal to what?
The drug freezing point
plus
NaCl added.
Freeze point.
NaCl added freeze point. The total freeze point is 0.52.
Why he is writing total as 0.52? 0.52 represents first 0.9% NaCl. 0.9% NaCl is what?
Isotonic.
To reach that isotonic, you need total depression of 0.52. But the doctor is given us to prepare some drug. Already due to presence of drug, some freeze point is depressed. Then he calculated how much is 0.03, just said. Okay, 1% it is 0.06, for 0.5% it is 0.03. Plus, how much adjusting substance you need to add? The added adjusting substance is NaCl. That's what he is going to find. Okay.
This is total freezing point. As we know that isotonic to the body and to the freeze point of drug, that is 0.05. 0.03. That is degrees known. That is in that. And we have to calculate now NS here. Consider it is as x. Consider it is as x. Now we are transferring this. X is equals to 0.52 minus 0.52 minus 0.03. And we, if we minus in it, we will get 0.49. That this is the freezing point of NaCl.
What you mean is that is the freeze point temperature of NaCl to be added.
To be added.
If we add how much NaCl, we need to calculate how much amount of NaCl we need to add to decrease the freeze point of 0.49. Now you calculate it. Maybe this is the reason you never thought this. It's not so easy to understand. So much concept involved in this.
And we have freezing point here 0.49. For 1% freezing point is?
Will you ask them, they will tell.
For 1% freezing point is
0.76.
And we have got, this is freezing point.
0.49.
And we have to calculate how much percentage is required. Now if we cross multiplication, then we will get 0.8506 will get. And this is the percentage. As we know, we are seeing percentage. This is percentage 506. This is percentage. Means 0.06% means 0.850 grams of dissolved in 100 ml. In the first, in the when we are seeing problem, they are giving to prepare only 10 ml. They are giving the question, we have to prepare for 10 ml. For 10 ml, how much amount of NaCl is required? For 10 ml, we have to transfer this. 0.8506 into 10 by 100. We will get
0.8506.
This is
the amount of
NaCl to be added, and the increase in grams. If we have, now we have to convert to mg. That is, we have to give. If we multiply into 1000, then we will get in mg. That is 85.06 mg. To make isotonic, we have to add 85.06 mg of NaCl to make isotonic with the chlorophenicol. We have seen in some way why we are studying in the pharmaceutical, about how to isotonic solutions, because the isotonic solutions are very important for day to day life. When we are preparing any dosage forms or any formulations like ophthalmic or parenteral, it should be isotonic to the body. If these isotonic solutions are not isotonic to the body, then it leads to complications. So this is the application. Now we are going to buffer solutions. The buffer solution is the solution which can resist the change in pH. And these are divided into two types. As acidic buffer, basic buffer. And we all know the composition of acidic and basic buffer. The composition is weak acid, salt of weak acid. And when we see basic weak base, salt of weak base. And weak base, weak acid and salt of weak acid, weak base and salt of weak base. This is the composition of buffer, and the buffers are used in our day-to-day life. in the manufacture of dyes, fabric and paints, in so many manufacturing products that these are using. The buffers are mainly used for the determination of pH, for the determination of pH and for the stability, purity. For all this purpose, we are using the buffer solutions. By using buffer solution, we can resist the pH. If the dosage form, if any dosage form, when we prepare, it should add buffer, because it should maintain some pH. If we are not adding buffer, then in the dosage form, it leads to so many changes. Then the dosage form won't be easily taken by a person. So the buffer solutions are very important in the day-to-day life for the maintaining the pH, stability and purity, and maintaining the purity. For all this purpose, we are using buffer solutions. And I want to tell this whole topic is finally, I want to conclude that buffer and isotonic solutions. The whole concept is buffered isotonic solutions. When we prepare any dosage form, it may be ophthalmic or parenteral. For all these dosage forms, we have to add buffer and isotonic, and we have to maintain isotonic solutions. Because when the dosage form is there, we should add buffer, because to maintain pH, and we have to maintain isotonic solution also, because the concentration should be suitable with the body. So this all concept is applicable in the dosage form. So we are studying this buffer solution and isotonic solution. And thank you for giving this opportunity.